It's important that you know we transition from prepared questions from the groups because we just have those ready. The main thing is to get to the questions that you folks have brought with you tonight. All the questions we're asking now are from the audience. And since we're in the Five Points area, we're in the area that's always been the middle section, I think this first question is really relevant for people here tonight. And this has to do with river bottoms, horse properties. They want to know, how are you going to protect this for them?
Well, through zoning, we just recently in the downtown area allowed several properties to keep their horses to rezone and to legally allow them now to keep the horses on the property that they currently have. And so we can do that in this area as well. It comes to the property owners and they petition the government for what they desire. And there's no reason for the city not to provide you all residents what you want in your own neighborhoods. If that's what you're calling for, or horse lifestyle, then that's what we'll get from your council, I'm assuming, and the rest of the city. So I don't see a conflict in that regard.
I think we can look at the partnerships. When you're looking at the Pine Pilots, there's a lot of partnerships, different types of partnerships between public and public-private. And I think that's what we need to look at here. If you're looking at protecting the river bottom, I think there could be a partnership between the city Riverside and the county Riverside, and maybe some private partnership involved. My wife has had horses for almost 30 years now. And to find places to ride, find places that are accessible, sometimes it's hard. So maybe we should open up some more access to the river bottom for some of the equestrian use in here. But the other thing that if you look at, there's zoning issues, and then you can have mitigation issues to where if there's a development in and around that area of the river, you can mitigate those developments by having to fund certain improvements to provide more access to the river bottom or to prevent the river bottom, whatever you're looking at. So those are some of my
two examples that I have spearheaded in this regard is Chapa Hill.
Anybody know where Chapa Hill is? There's a parcel on top of Chapa Hill that could have been purchased by the private sector. The Land Conservancy wanted to maintain that and undeveloped property. So they ended up taking a loan from the city and then paying us back over time. So now the Chapa Hill will remain in perpetuity undeveloped. We also have a 7-mile easement now we purchased from Western, I think it's Municipal Water District, MWD. It's going to allow a trail from the Orange Crest area all the way down to Victoria Avenue. So we are very attuned to the needs of undeveloped